DARE in sixth grade, like everyone else, I believed it all the way up until eighth grade when my DARE teacher actually got arrested with 2 pounds of scars and marijuana. Started scratching my head, but I kept saying, just saying no. All through high school, I never used marijuana, never even started drinking until I was 18. Then I started drinking pretty heavy when some family stuff started happening, some of my family members were getting sick left and right, and I couldn't deal with this. I started drinking on my own. I had alcohol in my family, and I've seen how that affects them. So I knew it was bad. I first tried marijuana at a party when I was just after I turned 18, second semester of high school. I didn't get high, you know, pretty drunk. And all I remember is it tasted really good, and the guy gave it to me was one of the most relaxed, smartest guys that I've ever met in college. He was on the Fortnite scholarship for 1 week. So that's why I said I need to do some research. So for my senior research paper in English, I compared marijuana and alcohol. I had no idea about marijuana, nothing about it, but I came to the realization that there's no reason for it to be illegal, and it's pretty much harmless when compared to the current drugs that we're able to use right now. And also, I work on those anyways, I went to Iowa State University. I graduated high school 3.5 and 29 on my ACT. I had a 4-year scholarship for personal financial debt. All I had to do was pass my classes, and they were going to give me a $20 an hour internship last summer. In February last year, I was arrested with just a pipe and like a half a gram. Not a big deal. I wanted to go to my parents, but with the family situation, I didn't want to be more stressful. So I figured I'll just take a $500 fine and be on probation for 6 months and be fine. I stopped using marijuana. My grades started dropping, and I started not being able to get out of bed. So I said, screw it, until I'm on probation, I'm going to use it to my depression problems I'm going through right now. On 4/20, there was some kind of huge bust in the morning. My dealer lived across the hall from me, had no weed. I wasn't able to get out of it, which sounds melodramatic compared to you guys. I mean, this is nothing. It's just some bullshit situation. Depression. Cool. Anyways, on 4/22, my dealer said, hey, I got a buddy. He has a pound. I'm going to go buy a QP. I said, well, finals in a week. I'm going to get a QP for the summer. It'll help me get through the summer, living with my parents. I'll get back out on my own in college, whatever. I bought a QP at 6 p.m. on 4/22. At 11 a.m. on 4/23, the DEA knocked on my door. I've never sold weed before. I just smoked. My dealer had been narked on by 500 people throughout the course of the year. They executed a search warrant on him, looked at his phone, and they had a thank you for me. So they came knocking on my door. I did not know my rights. I knocked off because he told me my life was over, and I just laughed through. I told him exactly what I thought of that. And I was on probation. They gave me like a $6,000 fine. I was in jail for a week. I was in jail up to 12 hours before my finals at Iowa State. And I said, at that point, I said, screw it, I'm not going to take my finals. Even without taking my finals, I passed 3 out of 5 of my classes. I have credit for that. I'm not a stupid person. Marijuana is absolutely harmless. The only thing that's happened to me that has hurt me from marijuana is that my family, apparently thinks I'm druggy from the very upset weed and alcohol. And I owe right now $30,000. I had $6,000. I went to work. I worked 60 hours a week, landscaping and making pizzas. Living with my parents, they were very mad at me. And I expected that. After a month and a half, it was 4th of July, they wanted me to be home by 12. I told them, it's too nice, 4th of July, I'm going out for the first time this summer. I came home, smelled my weed, so they kicked me out. But I also got some other things, because I'm also kind of an asshole. Anyways. So they kicked me out and said, listen, just come back and you're fine. And I was so awestruck into the fact that they weren't able to understand that it's not that harmful of a substance, considering my mom had on 2 separate occasions back in the 90s hooked my uncle up with marijuana while he was going through chemo for testicular cancer. So I was angry, stubborn, and an asshole, and decided to get a third job. So I started working 80 hours a week. I did that all last summer for a couple months. I was able to pay out most of my fines and get an apartment. I paid for it to go back to school part-time and was working 50 hours a week at the Walmart in the fall last year. Then I wasn't smoking weed. I fell into a severe depression again and hadn't been talking to my parents, but they started, after seeing all the stuff I'd done throughout the summer, started talking to me again. And because of that, in my opinion, in my viewpoint at the time, their hypocrisy drove me crazy. I wanted to be off probation. I owed $2,000 more. So one night, while at Walmart, I stole $7,000 from iPods with the hope of selling them. With the hope of selling them, paying off my probation, being able to smoke and get up. I got caught. I'm in a little bit of trouble for that. I'm really lucky I'm not a felon and I'm not in prison right now. I paid an extra $50,000 for this to be able to actually come to something like this. So I'm like, why the hell not? Right now, I owe the government $16,000 in fines. I just found a job a week ago in NAR. Actually, sorry about the nine. I just realized I forgot to take it off. I got off work before I came here. Basically, I'm kind of ranting. I want to find an opportunity to talk to the car by getting involved really quick. I'm pissed. It's the only thing keeping me warm right now. I want to kick this bullshit off the front to do it. It's absolutely ridiculous. If I remember smoking marijuana, I wouldn't be in so much trouble legally, but back a year ago when I was smoking marijuana, I might not be.